Hello friends, how are you? I hope you're doing very good. Here I am, Ruchi Jain. Welcome to my channel, Learn German the Easy Way. Here in the series of subordinating conjunctions, this video is part 2 of the same video. So are you ready to learn something new today? Let's use this time when you are in your houses. You can learn online. Here in this video, you are going to learn few subordinating conjunctions like before, obwohl, bis, and many more. I hope you will enjoy this video. And before going further, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please do consider to subscribe it. Definitely you will learn a lot of new things. So are you ready? Let's go ahead. Before going further, let's first understand what is subordinating conjunction. In German language, we call it Subjunktion. Subjunktion. In very simple words, I have explained it here. Let's read it. Subjunktion or subordinating conjunction, which is called in English. It is actually grammatically, it can be explained as a word which comes at the beginning of a subordinate clause and helps to explain its nature. I think these simple words, the explanation in these simple words will help you to understand what exactly it is. In German language, actually, conjunctions are of two types: coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. The first type, conjunctions, coordinates two clauses that are equally important, while the second type subordinates one clause to another. This is the simple way to understand it. When you use subordinating conjunctions, verb goes at the end of the clause that is introduced by the conjunction. When using coordinating conjunctions, the verb stays in the same position, usually. This is the second position after the subject in the sentence. But it is not always like this. So be careful while using it. The more you will practice, the better you will get using all these conjunctions and Subjunktionen. Let's go ahead. Let's see the list of subordinating conjunction which we are including in this video. The first word is, first conjunction is ob, which means whether or if in English. Our second subjunction is obwohl, although, though, even though. Obwohl in English we call it although, though, or even though. Next word is als. In English, then, when we have a comparative degree, when or as. Next one is before. In English, we call it before or prior. Here you can see V is pronounced as F. That is why it is before. Next word is bis, which means until in English. And the last one is während, during, while, or whereas. These are the English versions of this word während. Let's go ahead and try to understand how to use these words. What will be the structure of the sentence? The first word here we have taken is ob, which means whether or if. Let's see the example. They want to know, I'm so sorry. Our next word is obwohl, which means although or though. Let's understand how to use this word in a sentence. Let's take this example. He is going to work though he is not feeling well today. He is going to work though he is not feeling well today. Now, how to translate this sentence into German? Er geht zur Arbeit, obwohl sich heute nicht wohl fühlt. Er geht zur Arbeit, obwohl sich heute nicht wohl fühlt. Here you can see again with obwohl, the verb position is at the last of the sentence, at the end of the sentence. The verb is wohl fühlen. Here you can see, you can take another example as well and do write some examples using these words in the comment section. So it's very simple and understandable how to use word obwohl. Let's go ahead. Our next word is als, which means when or as. Let's see this example. When I was a child, I wanted to become author. When I was a child, I wanted to become author. Als ich ein Kind war, wollte ich Autor werden. Als ich ein Kind war, wollte ich Autor werden. Here you can see we have started the sentence using als, the subordinating clause. The word position is at the end of the sentence, the first sentence, and then the next sentence is starting with the verb. That is how also you can write. Or you can also say ich wollte Autor werden, comma, als ich ein Kind war. That is how also you can write. Huh? Both are correct. But it sounds much better. That is why I have written it like this. Als ich ein Kind war, wollte ich Autor werden. I hope it's clear how to use als. Let's go ahead. Our next word is before. In English also, before. Let's see this example. You must complete your homework before we play football. Let's translate this sentence into German. Du musst deine Hausaufgabe machen, bevor wir Fußball spielen. Du musst deine Hausaufgabe machen, bevor wir Fußball spielen. Here you can see again the verb position. Check out the verb position in the second sentence. The sentence starting with the conjunction, the subjunction before, and the verb is at the end of the sentence. Quite easy. The first sentence is with modal verb and the second sentence we are starting it with before. That's the subjunction or the subordinating conjunction. The verb position is at the end of the sentence. Very easy to understand. Let's go ahead. Our next word is bis, which means until. Let's see this example. I will stay at home until the rain stops. I'll stay at home until the rain stops. Let's see the German version of this sentence. Ich bleibe zu Hause. Ich bleibe zu Hause bis es zu Regen aufhört. Ich bleibe zu Hause bis es zu Regen aufhört. Here the verb is aufhören, which means to stop. Again, with bis, the verb position is at the end of the sentence. And the subordinating clause is starting with the word bis. Quite easy to understand. Let's go ahead. I hope it is clear to all of you. Our last word for this video is während, which means during or while. Let's understand how to use this word by this example. While I clean the room, you must wash the car. That's the example. Let's see how to translate this sentence in German language. Während ich das Zimmer aufräume, musst du das Auto waschen. Während ich das Zimmer aufräume, musst du das Auto waschen. Quite clear, quite understandable. Here again we have started with während and the verb position is at the end of the first sentence. Aufräume. That is again the verb is aufräumen. Moose du das Auto waschen. The second sentence is a modal verb sentence. You can also say du musst das Auto waschen, während ich das Zimmer aufräume. That is also correct. So that is how we use these subjunctionen or subordinating conjunctions. I hope it is clear now how to use them. Do write few examples in the comment section. Thank you. Thank you very much. Danke. Vielen Dank. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, please do consider to subscribe it. And do not forget to ring the bell. Do share it with your friends whosoever want to learn German. Okay, thank you. Tschüss. Auf Wiedersehen. See you again soon. Bye.